A very, very strong character, very prolific in our region, I'd say, with Rey. And just ridiculously strong in this neutral.
Yeah, and it's like every special Geo has is plus. Like you saw that heal kit.
The only plus, exception like the plus. Is the DP.
The DP.
It's relatively safe. Like
yeah, -15 if I'm not mistaken.
We're seeing exactly what needs to happen against the Tekken in this matchup right now from the kill stage. Just absolutely rushing him down, not giving him a second's time to breathe. Oh, but the pot buster on wake up. And this is how Pot turns things around, ladies and gentlemen. Getting a solid poke there. Trying to edge his way in with the hammer break. Looking for that opportunity. Solid pokes here. Very patient play from Kirby Combo 35.
I'm going to need to start FDing right now as Kirby Combo.
Whitehead coming through. The burst going to pop from the kill stage. Gets the pick off of the far slash as well. We saw some very quick adjustment from Kirby there. Playing that neutral very well despite being only at like a pixel's health.
Exactly. So let's see how this round goes then.
Very solid pressure.
Yeah, that's my best plus. Gotta interrupt it.
Yeah, he absolutely cannot afford to respect those, or he's gonna end up in the corner for a very long time, ladies and gentlemen. Excellent bait on the whiffed overhead there, and that is gonna be the burst. The lifeline is gone for Potemkin here. Gonna have to find his way out. He needs to take care of those spiral arrows, Koma.
Yeah, exactly. It's plus, so you don't really want to do anything after you block it, but you want to interrupt it, is how you want to deal with that. And wow, all that wrist gauge. Wrist crank did all that damage on Potemkin.
Yeah. It paid off huge, especially using that super against the corner, getting that extra damage. Really, really strong stuff from the kill sage. All right, and off the bat, hitting him with the counter hit, going right into that offense. Kirby combo just being smothered by this aggression, able to finally turn things around just a little bit.
Backdash,
excellent backdash coming through from the kill sage here, recognizing that pop buster. All right, going for the slide head just a little bit too
early. Was that an anti-air slide?
Yeah,
not entirely sure. It does have armor, but.
Yes. Oh!
Try the Gerudo.
Yeah, that's a real gutsy option there. Going for the PRC, or the red RC. I always try to call it pink RC. It messes me up, man. All right, solid counter hit coming through. The kill stage not respecting this Oki at all. Gets him with the tick throw.
Yeah, so you saw those counter, like you're saying, that counter hit, the heavy counter hits, I believe they're called like heavy counter hits in this game, they increase the hit stun for a certain amount of time. So less combos, like you see there, like less combos that usually aren't possible, they're possible. Like you saw this heavy in the spiral arrow into, you know, confirm off that.
And Kirby like combo here. 35 just not able to time his medias correctly here, and Kill Sage is taking a huge advantage from it.
Yeah, Kill Sage is going in right now.
Ooh. Oh, there it is, though, the meaty. Not quite able
tried
to capitalize.
Every time you see the 6P, the prayer, every time you see the prayer, you know it was a pot, you know
I'm
it was
actually,
a pot buster.
I'm looking surprised, because off of that meaty, you can get heavenly.
Yeah,
if it
you get
gets.
Heavenly off
yeah.
that? Okay.
You go straight into that 2HS, and they are gone. That said, taking it 2-0 is the kill sage over Kirby Combo 35. Mm-hmm. Like I said, the Smash players coming out of the woodwork, man. Switching to a real game, finally. Love to see it.
Oh, that's a Smash player? I mean, I would assume
I mean, his
so
name is
name,
Kirby Combo 35, so like, it's
going to
be
so.
It's going to be great when he DMs me on Twitter tomorrow, like, dude, I don't play Smash. I've never heard of that game. Kirby's my name, man. solid stuff, though. Yeah, I mean, you really got to learn your meaties, Koma. Mm-hmm, that's all I got to say after watching that matchup. You got to learn your meaty timings. Very important in this game, especially playing a character like Potemkin, where you're not going to be doing a lot of safe jumping.
Exactly. I talk about it all the time with, like, meaties. I go all the way back to Xard. I was talking about it. This game, I talk about it, especially now because you know if somebody is a meaty if they get thrown on wake up. So if they're getting thrown on wake up because throws on the, throws are 2 frames and not 1 frame like they previously were, then you know they just didn't meaty properly. Mm-hmm. So yeah, that's a big thing. Just, you know, learn your meaties, use your high active move if you have to.
Yeah, no, it's two simple pieces of advice here to get good at Guilty Gear. You eat your Wheaties, you grow big and strong, and you learn your meaties so you don't get hit on wake-ups. Solid stuff, though. To Kill Sage, doing such a great job of recognizing those flaws in his opponent's defense and his offense, and catching him off for it with those counter hits. So huge for Giovanna. Kind of a reactive character, honestly.
Very. I think so. I like the pressure from the Kill Sage, too. Using a lot of the Spire Arrows, just recognize that the opponent essentially not really going to stop you from doing it.
He got away with the knowledge there. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, like, why not just go for it? Why not just keep doing it? Then if your opponent isn't going to stop you, just, you know, keep doing it, build that risk, and then the next hit, you did like 56% to Potemkin.
Man, you're preaching to the choir. I play chip.